How are you fine, students? I hope you all are fine and safe by the grace of God. Students, stay in your home safe and you should prepare day-to-day questions well. Okay, students, now we are learning Geography Lesson 5, India, Population, Transport, Communication and Trade, is it? In the beginning of this class, we can recollect few important points about previous class question. Okay, students, in the previous class, which topic we learned? Have you remember? We learned about population. First of all, we learned about population, is it? Students, now I am asking few questions from population. You should bring the answer in your mind. Okay, students?
The first question is, what is meant by population? The total number of people residing in a country at a specific period of time is called the population of that country. Is it? What is meant by population? The total number of people residing in a country at a specific period of time is called the population of that country. Is it? Then, next we learned about population census. Is it? Next we learned about population census. The next question, what is meant by census? Very good. Population census is the total process of collecting, compiling and analyzing at a specific time of all person in a country or a world. Is it? It happens 10 years once. Is it, students? Then, next we learned about distribution and density of population. Is it? Next we learned about distribution and density of population. What is meant by distribution and density of population? It refers in the ways the people are spaced over the earth surface. Is it? From this topic, we learned some of the important things. Next I am going to ask next question. Which is the most populous state in India? Which is the most populous state in India? Very good. The answer is Uttar Pradesh. Is it? Then I am going to ask the second question. Which is the least population state in India? Excellent. The answer is Sikkim. Is it? Then among the union territories, which union territory is the most populated territory? Very good. Answer is Delhi. Is it? Then next we learned about density of population. Next, we learned about density of population. Is it? What is meant by density of population? It is the measure of understanding the various distribution of population. Is it? It is the measure of understanding the various distribution of population. Then, which is the most populated country in the world? Very good. Answer is India. Is it? Then the next question, which state is the most densely populated state in India? Answer is Bihar. Is it, students? Okay. Finally, we learned about population growth and change. Is it? Finally, we learned about population growth and change. Firstly, what is meant by population growth? Very good. Population growth refers to the change in the number of inhabitants of a country. Is it? What is meant by population growth? Population growth refers to the change in number of inhabitants of a country. Is it? Then, next question. What is meant by population change? Population change refers to an increase or decrease of population of an area from one period to another period. What is meant by population change? Very good. Population change refers to an increase or decrease of population of an area from one period to another period. Is it? These are the things we learned in the previous class. Okay, students? Did you learn that topic exercises, students? Very good. Okay, students. Now let us come forward to today's class. Okay. Today we are going to learn migration and urbanization. First of all, we are going to learn migration. Okay. What is meant by migration? Migration is the movement of people across regions and territories. What is mean by migration? Migration is the movement of people across regions and territories. It can be internal migration and international migration. It can be internal migration and international migration. Okay. Internal means within a country. Internal means within a country. And international means between the countries. Okay. International means between the country. Internal migration does not change the size of population. Internal migration does not change the size of population, but international migration will change the size of population. Then, according to 2011 census, 37% of population are migrants in India. According to 2011 census, 37% of population are migrants in India. Among them, 48% from female and 52% from male. Okay. From migration, now we are going to learn some types. There are seven types are there. The first one is population composition. What is mean by population composition? Population composition refers to the characteristics such as age, sex, martial status, caste, religion, language, education, occupation, etc. What are the things composed in population, students? Age, sex, martial status, caste, religion, language, education, occupation, etc. Okay, then it helps us to understand the social, economic and demographic structure of population. Okay, it helps us to understand the social, economic and demographic structure of population. Okay, then the second type is age composition. Okay, what is mean by age composition? It refers to the number of people to different age groups in a country. What is mean by age population? It refers to the number of people to different age groups in a country. It is the basic characteristics of population. It helps us to understand the dependent and independent category. Okay. It helps us to understand the dependent and independent category. Which one support to understand the age and age composition? We know about with the help of the dependent and independent category. Okay. Then, this age composition is classified into three groups. First one, the children. That means who has less than 15 years age. Then the second one is who has up to 16 to 59 age. Then the third one is people who has above the age of 60. Okay. Okay, students. The next topic is sex ratio. Okay. Sex ratio is defined as the number of females per 1000 men population. What is mean by sex ratio? Sex ratio defined as the number of females per 1000 men population. Okay. Sex ratio is defined as number of females per 1000 men population. In 2011 census, the sex ratio of country is 940 females per 1000 males. Listen very careful. In 2011 census, the sex ratio of country is 940 females per 1000 males. It shows the size of the female population is less than males. It shows the size of the female population is less than males. Okay. Then the state of Kerala and the Union Territory of Puducherry, the sex ratio is greater than 1000. In India, only one state and one union territory is territory sex ratio is greater than 1000. That is Kerala and Puducherry. Listen here. The state of Kerala and the Union Territory of Puducherry, the sex ratio is greater than 1000. Okay. Then the lower sex ratio is the Union Territory of Diu and Daman. The lower sex ratio is the Union Territory of Diu and Daman. Okay. Okay, students. The next one is literacy rate. The next one is literacy rate. What is mean by literacy? Literacy means the people who are able to read and write. Literacy means the people who are able to read and write. Then, what is mean by literacy rate? What is mean by literacy rate? Literacy rate means the percentage of literate people to the total population. What is mean by literacy rate? Literacy rate means the percentage of literate people to the total population. I will repeat, what is mean by literacy? Literacy means the people who are able to read and write. Is it? Then what is mean by literacy rate? Literacy rate means the percentage of literate people to the total population. According to 2011 census, India's literacy rate is 74.04%. According to 2011 census, India's literacy rate is 74.04%. From this, 82.14% of male and 65.46% of female. Okay. Then, Kerala is the highest literacy rate state in India. Which is the highest literacy rate state in India? Kerala. Which is the highest literacy rate in the state of India? Kerala. How much percentage? 93.91%. How much percentage? 93.91% people are literate people in Kerala. Then, Bihar is the lowest literacy rate state in India. Bihar is the lowest literacy rate state in India. Which is the lowest literacy state in India? Answer is Bihar. Okay, students. Then, the next one is occupational structure. The next type is occupational structure. Okay. In India, the workers are classified into three categories. In India, the workers are classified into three categories. They are main workers, marginal workers, and non-workers. In India, the workers are classified into three categories. They are main workers, marginal workers, and non-workers. Okay. Now, the first one is main workers. The first one is main workers. Okay. Main workers means those who are able to work more than 6 months per year, they are regarded as main workers. I will repeat. Listen very carefully. Main workers means those who are able to work more than 6 months per year, they are regarded as main workers. Those who are able to work more than 6 months per year, they are regarded as main workers. Okay. Then the second one is marginal workers. The second one is marginal workers. People who are able to work less than 6 months, they are regarded marginal workers. Listen very carefully. People who are able to work less than 6 months, they are regarded marginal workers. Okay, students. Then the third one is non-workers. The third one is non-workers. Who have not worked at all, they are regarded non-workers. Okay, students. Then the sixth type is population dynamics. The next type is population dynamics. Okay. What is mean by population dynamics? It refers to the changes in the size of population and its characteristics. What is mean by population dynamics? Population dynamics refers to the changes in the size of population and its characteristics. Okay, then the last one is problems of overpopulation. The last type is problems of overpopulation. The overpopulation brings some problems in the areas of socio-economic, political and environment. Some of the major problems created the overpopulation. Okay, what are the important problems created the overpopulation means? Overcrowd, unemployment, low standard of living and unhealthy environment. Okay, overcrowd, unemployment, low standard of living and unhealthy environment. Okay, students, then these are the seven types of migration. These are the seven types of migration. Okay, students, can you understand? Now, shall we recall the points? Now, we learned about migration. Is it? Now, we learned about migration. What is mean by migration? Migration is the movement of people across regions and territories. Is it? Migration is the movement of people across regions and territories. It can be internal and international. Is it? Internal and international. Internal migration means within a country. Within a country, that means the people move from one district to district, or rural area to urban area, or one state to other state. That only internal migration. Okay, then next one is international migration. International migration means between the country. International migration means between the country. Then between the country, that means the people move from one country to other country. One country to other country. It plays an important role in changing the composition of distribution of population. The next we learned about the different types of migration. There are seven types of migrations are there. The first one is population composition. Second one is age composition. Third one is sex ratio. Fourth one is literacy rate. Fifth one is occupational structure. Sixth one is population dynamics, and the last one is problems of overpopulation. Is it? Okay, students, now I hope you understood about migration. Okay, students, now I am going to explain urbanization. The next topic is urbanization. Okay, what is meant by urbanization? Urbanization is the process of society's transformation from rural to urban. Urbanization is the process of society's transformation from rural to urban. That means the people move from rural area to urban area. Okay. The level of urbanization is the size of population. The level of urbanization is the size of population. Okay. Then urbanization in India. Urbanization in India. It is measured by the percentage of urban population. Urbanization in India. How to measure urbanization in India? Urbanization in India is measured by the percentage of urban population. Okay. The percentage of urban population in India are 31.16% in 2011 census. The percentage of urban population in India are 31.16% in 2011 census. Okay, from here, Goa is the most urbanized state. Goa is the most urbanized state in India. That means with 62.17% of urban population in Goa. 62.17% of urban population in Goa. Okay, then Himachal Pradesh is the least urbanized state. Himachal Pradesh is the least urbanized state. That means 10.04% of urban population in Himachal Pradesh. 10.04% of urban population in Himachal Pradesh. Among union territories, Delhi is the most urbanized population. Among union territories, Delhi is the most urban population. Okay. Then the next one is impact of urbanization. The next one is impact of urbanization. The impact of urbanization is related to hand to hand. The impact of urbanization is related to hand to hand. Now, the following are the major problems of urbanization. There are some problems in urbanization. 9 problems are there. Now, I am going to explain. The first one is it creates urban sprawl. The first one is it creates urban sprawl. Sprawl means to cover large area of a land. To cover large area of land. Okay. Then second important problem is it makes overcrowding in urban center. It makes overcrowding in urban center. Okay. Then the third one is it leads the shortage of houses in urban area. It leads the shortage of houses in urban area because from rural to the people are moving urban areas, is it? So there is shortage of houses. Then the next one is, fourth one is, it leads to the formation of slums. It leads to the formation of slums. Slums means an area of a city extremely bad. Slums means an area of a city extremely bad. Okay. Then the fifth one is, it increases traffic congestion in cities. It increases traffic congestion in cities because the overpopulation of urban area, there will occur traffic jam. Okay. Then the sixth one is, it creates water scarcity in cities. It creates water scarcity in cities. What is meant by scarcity? Shortage. Oh, because of overpopulation in the urban areas will get shortage in water. Shortage of water. Okay. Then the seventh one is it creates drainage problems. The seventh one is it creates drainage problem. Drainage. If where there is no drainage, it that areas will occur. Water logging, in the previous lesson I taught, is it? Water logging, is it? It is also one of the main problem of urbanization in India. Then the eighth one is, it possesses the problems of solid waste management. It possesses the problems of solid waste management. There is no area places, so the land soil pollution will occur. Then the ninth one is, it creates the rate of crime. Ninth one is, it creates the rate of crime. That means because of overpopulation, the all people won't get the employment, is it? So, it creates the rate of crime. These are the major problems of urbanization. These are the major problems of urbanization. Can you understand, students? Shall we recall the points? Now, we learned about urbanization, is it? What is meant by urbanization? Urbanization is the process of society's transformation from rural to urban. Urbanization means it is the process of society's transformation from rural to urban. Is it? Then next we learned about urbanization in India. Is it? Urbanization in India. It is measured by the percentage of urban population. It is measured by the population of urban population. Is it? The percentage of urban population in India are very good. 31.16%. Okay. In 2011 census. 31.16%. Then, which is the most urbanized state in India? Very good. Goa is the most urbanized state in India. 62.17% of urban population in Goa. Okay. Then which is the least urban state? Himachal Pradesh. Which is the least urban state in India? Himachal Pradesh. 10.04% of urban population. Okay. Then among union territories, which is the most urbanized state? Urbanized territories? Delhi. Delhi is the most urbanized state. Okay. Then next we learned about impact of urbanization. Next we learned about impact of urbanization. Is it? Impact of urbanization is related to hand to hand. Impact of urbanization is related to hand to hand. Some of the major problems of urbanization. There are 9 problems of urbanization. Is it? The first one is it creates urban sprawl. It creates urban sprawl. Second one is it makes overcrowding in urban centers. The next one is, it leads to the shortage of houses in urban areas. The next one is, it leads to the formation of slums. Then fifth one is, it increases traffic congestion in cities. Sixth one is, it creates water scarcity in Indian cities. Then it creates drainage problem. The eighth one is, it poses the problems of solid waste management. The ninth one is, it creates the rate of crime. These are the major problems of urbanization. Okay, students, can you understand? I hope you understood about migration and urbanization. The next, the continuation of this topic, I will teach the next class. Okay, students.
Now, all of your book, turn the exercises page, page number 199. Page number 199. Roman number 3. Answer the following question briefly. First question, what is migration? States its type. Two types of questions are there in the first question. Is it? What is migration? States its type. Tan page number 188. Tan page number 188. Migration heading. Migration heading. First three lines. It is the movement of people across regions and territories. It can be internal or international. Close the bracket. Then it's type 1 to mark. Seven types are there. On the heading, the next heading, population composition, age composition, sex ratio, literacy rate, occupational structure, population dynamics, problems of overpopulation. That's seven headings alone you should mark. Then, next question, Roman number 5, answer the following in a paragraph. First question, what is urbanization? Explain its problem. Chant page number 189. Urbanization reading. First paragraph, the process of society's transformation from rural to urban is known as urbanization. First para, mark it. Then the next heading, impact of urbanization. First paragraph, fully. Then continuously, the following are the major problems of urbanization in India. There are 9 points are given. That 9 points together you should mark. Then some one by question you should prepare from book. Each line by line you should read. Then you mark the question. For example, which is the highest literacy rate state in India? Which states? Kerala. That literacy rate paragraph inside it is there. Then lowest literacy rate, Bihar. Literacy rate paragraph last before third line, you mark it. The highest literacy rate state is Kerala, 93.91%. Then the lowest literacy rate is found in Bihar, 63.82%. Likewise, each paragraph, line by line, you read and mark the one-word question. Okay, book inside one-word question. Okay, students, the continuation of this lesson, I will teach the next class. Thank you, students.